Hey guys, I recently Keqing for Keqing and got the Mistsplitter reforged for her. The sword has a crit damage secondary stat and its passive provides a 40% elemental damage bonus at 3 stacks. When I first saw it, I was like, Keqing's buff. So how do you proc the Mistsplitter stacks with Keqing? When you use an elemental infused auto attacks, you gain 1 stack for 5 seconds. However, spamming it 3 times doesn't give you 3 stacks. Keqing gains 1 stack for 10 seconds when she uses a burst, and when her energy is not full, she will have 1 stack forever. Keqing can keep 3 Mistsplitter stacks up with minimal downtime, but it might require some time to get the hang of rotations, especially in longer fights. Anyway, here are some ways that I use to get them stacks for their juicy elemental damage bonuses. The Mistsplitter has a crit damage secondary stat. Previously I was a Jade cutter user, so I had to change my artifacts around to balance my crit rate and damage ratio. I'm a big fan of the 4-piece Thunder Suitor set because it has a better damage output compared to my other artifact set game. I'm not going for a tank Keqing, goey defense. Artifacts buff when. And yes, I have yet to unlock my Keqing's constellation, and my Keqing is triple crowned. So which sword is Keqing's current best in slot? I feel the Jade Cutter crit rate is more valuable compared to the Mistsplitter crit damage secondary stat, and its passive provides an attack bonus which scales off her max HP, which makes rolling on HP artifacts substats kinda not a complete L. Since I have the Jade Cutter, I decided to test out both swords' DPS. Okay guys, TLDR time. What do I like about the Mistsplitter Reforged? The crit damage and high base attack is swiped up, and the 40% elemental damage bonus passive is juicy AF. it will definitely amp up Keqing's damage, but there's always a but. Even though Keqing's kit can keep 3 Mistsplitter stacks up with minimal downtime, however, in a panic steal moment, it might be kinda hard. Unlike the Jade Cutter, where you don't have to do anything to fulfill the weapon's passive, and you have to fight a tougher opponent called the Weapon Banner to get it. Even with the new PT system, it is not a free-to-play friendly option unless you saved up, or Luxac, or you Keqing for Keqing. But the best thing about the Mistsplitter is, it looks cute on Keqing.